NerdDice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 85 in our series, Create a RubyGem, NerdDice. And in our previous episode, we went and merged the feature for the NerdDice convenience methods into master. We've been working on that since episode 66 of this series, and you go down the all that stuff is into the README. In our last episode, we wound up extending those convenience methods into the NerdDice module itself, so that you can call NerdDice dot roll d20 and have it work dynamically with all those patterns that we've done throughout the course of these episodes. So, like I did before, I'm going to check the dependencies that are in our gem file, make sure that none of them have in our gem spec, make sure that check to see whether any of them have incremented or anything like that. If they have, I'll update the bundle, and we'll go from there. So I'll go to rubygems.org and I'm going to open up that gem spec in another screen so that I can go through these and see. All right, so let's check out coveralls reborn 0.23. So there was a release in September 2021. I will try, so we'll attempt to bump that. In the gem spec. Rubocop. That is fairly recent. So we'll add that in. RubyGem performance. Is what we had, so that doesn't need to be updated. RubyGem rake 0.6, that's where it was. RubyGem rspec is at 2.5, so we had a release on that. I'll bring that into the gem spec, and then simple cove, elk cove. That's what we've got. I also need secure random a release on that. recently. And then in my gem file, I have rxspec and rake. I'll take a look at those as well. So bring rxspec up to 3.10. Rake. 13.0.6. And we'll try bundle update. Seems to be fine. All right, we've got new cops. So I'll try adding those new cops to the spec. See what happens. I'll go here to .rubocop.yml. Alright, so the new cops aren't giving us any trouble. We'll incorporate them. The let's see here. NerdDice benchmark. Still working with a new version of rake. Let's take a look at our diff here. So our gem file dot lock. Everything looks fine there. Looks like we dropped a dependency in rubocop rxspec, which I'm fine with. And then our specs here. So that looks good. Check. Next, we go to the changelog. Saved. We'll make master unreleased blank, and then we'll add in a section for 0.4. October 23rd, 2021, version 0.4. I think we're good there. All right, so the next step is to commit the new changes and push to master. write my commit message. Got my message. Push to the remote. While we're waiting for our GitHub action to complete, I'm going to build the gem. Pause and type my passphrase. Pausing snafu there, so I just after building the providing my pen passphrase, I the gem was built into the root directory of the gem. I moved it to the package directory there, so that's where we stand there. I'm gonna check on the GitHub action now. Passed there. So the next step of this release is to check locally, make sure that I can install the gem with high security. So I'll go to package, seems to have worked. Going to now remove that version of the gem so that I can install it from RubyGems after I push it. So we're going to do a gem uninstall. Successfully uninstalled it. Now, I'm going to think the next thing is to push to RubyGem. So, we shall do that. So, we'll do a gem push. RubyGems successfully registered the gem. It should show on RubyGems now. That's version 0.4.0. How exciting. So now I'm going to test that I can install the gem with high security from RubyGems. Yep, I'm in the root directory. So to work for a few minutes. In the meantime, I will tag the release for GitHub or Git tag the 0.4.0. All right, so we'll tag this. Tag the 0.4.0 dash a dash dash sign our message nerd dice gem 0.4.0 release. Get our log. It's got the tag on it. All right, so we'll git push tags. Go to GitHub. Why is that still showing it yellow? Because of the pushing of the tag. I will go into releases here. Create a release off of this tag. All right, so I got my GitHub release written. It is published and released to make sure that the action passed. It did. So NerdDice CI is passing. Coverage is perfect on it. The gem is released. Let's go back in and see if we can do the high security install now. We can. So we've got that taken care of. Time to generate the checksums. Maybe I'm in the wrong directory. Oh, I need to do it with the correct version. So we'll generate the checksums for 0.4.0. Take a look at those, make sure they match what we've got in RubyGems. So our latest release is A74 ending with DF5. A74 DF5. All right. So we're good there. I will so learning from last time, I'm going to check in or commit these checksums as a separate commit, check out the 0.4.x stable branch, and then bump the version and run bundle install on it. So going to do the one-liner message because it's self-explanatory. We will do a git push. Take a look at our branches. We can get rid of feature convenience methods. version 0.4.x stable. Git push u origin. Stable. We will delete feature convenience methods from the origin. Without the funky characters. Take a look at GitHub. Make sure nothing funky happened with the GitHub actions. We're good there. Now I'm going to bump the version. Run a bundle update. Make sure our spec still works. RubyGem still works. Good. Commit this. I guess the one-liner would have worked there. Push. Any other housekeeping I need to take care of for this release? Oh, I was paused. So what I did, I accidentally pushed the change on the version, bumping it up to 0.5 to the 0.4.x branch because I forgot to switch back to master before doing the commit. So I did a git merge fast forward only into master and then a git reset hard to the previous commit on that and then pushed to both branches. You can see in the GitHub actions there, the bump version is 0.5 was on 0.4 stable and now 0.5 is on master. 0.4 stables on 0.4. So 0.4 stable should have 78 commits. It does. And master is pointing to 0.5. But this has been a really fun epic, and we'll see you next episode in the retro for this magic methods epic. Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.